Back for part two since it got cut off. I'm trying to record straight off the phone and you shoot and post it directly because then I just forget to post videos on here, which is very bad. So I'm just going to do it this way since for some reason I'm actually able to get the information out a bit better than when I do over voice over work on it. For each strand of hair, I'm doing dagger strokes, which basically is doing this, making sure it tapers off to a flare, so a super soft one. And I'm trying to get them as far in between and in different shapes. And then I'm gonna throw right here with the black, solid black. To give it that contrast, and then whatever's left over, I'm just gonna pull it off with the eraser. Oh, the tip dry messes it all up. Do some scattered black solid lines here and there. And then in this whole area is gonna be solid black in the reference picture. Well, let's see. So once we put here solid black paint here, this will soften up real quick. And then with the eraser that I'm gonna pull the highlights, it's gonna give it that illusion that it's light. Kind of like this right here on this painting. Same technique, same illusion. And where it's solid black, just commit to the color to make sure you have one clean even line and feather it into the area you're gonna work it into. Since I want this to be crisp and clean to maintain that the clear tone of the hair, I gotta make sure I point the airbrush inwards away from the hair and kind of try to avoid this unless you have a masking on it. But just aim this way and get tight on it so all the overspray catches on this side and you have a clean line like right here. And I'm just gonna stop short from hitting the actual face and the cheekbone line, and I'm gonna come in with the other black paint and shape it up softly with the stencil, because I'm already getting a lot of overspray, but I'm just gonna work into it. Right now I'm going to be using the abrasive sand eraser, the long one with the stick, or it's a stick, and just pull the hair down in the direction of the hair for the highlight to pull it out. And if you're using a hard surface, it's slick or a bit of glossier paper, you'll get a better, cleaner line. This is watercolor paper, so it's gonna pull it differently, but you'll still get the same illusion. And if you pull too much, you just come back over with the paint and dust it over. Oh, it's scanning there. And slowly chisel it out. Ugh. Yeah, speaking of chewing gum's not the best thing to do. Oh well. Yeah, kind of right now it looks like she has a beard and mustache going on. But we'll fix that. and just follow the shape of the hair so it looks natural. And you can do, you don't have to do each single strand. You just do about 5 or 6 major strands with definitive lines, and then do an overspray over the whole thing. And the amount of paint that you use. See, like right now, I'm just doing a few here and there. And then I want to move to another area, and I'm going to come back with the black to punch out some areas, erase for the highlight strands, and push it back again with the paint. With the straight black now. Crazy strands of hair, and then pull it out. You get those highlight ones. And if you're able, use a flat sharp edge of the eraser to get a straight line. If I was able to, I would use the X-Acto blade to pull it off. But on the paper, it just rips it off. Let me try it. Okay, it does it. But yeah, see, you can do it too much. And you can barely tell on the screen, but the strands are in there. and go back into some dusting and till you get what you want to do. And this is all monochromatic. If you did it with a full color scale or black and gray with actual gray values, you could actually just use white paint. But I'm just trying to use the background as highlights for the most part, and just use black and transparent black, just reduced to watercolor. Status basically. See, I don't know if you can tell. Let me zoom it up. Yeah, see, like right here. That's what happens when you don't clear out your airbrush. With the airbrush, you're supposed to always have the air on, even if you're not letting any paint out. Because if you stop pushing out the air, paint will build up on the tip. And once you actually start using it, you have a little blowout and you spat all over your image. So you see the little strand right here, the little droplet? I aimed right here on the edge of the lip and shattered everywhere. So I'm gonna blend it all out. And to give like volume and definition to the lips with the airbrush, what I do is just do arches all around and the direction of the lips that you see in the reference. The lightest, the better, to give it some texture so you can build it up. And then I go over it with some paper that has torn edges on it, what people call freehand shield. Just rip the paper off, and whatever pattern you have, that's what you use to get some sharp edges for the textured lines. And just put the piece of paper all against the surface. And just go softly. To get that straight edge line of that texture. Now mix with the old lines I did by hand, and then this, it pushes out the lips even more. Then I'm gonna shadow it off on the top and bottom, and I'm gonna come back with the eraser to pull some little areas here and there, keep it all random. I don't know where's my pencils. Oh, it's right there. It's a pencil eraser. And you just kind of pull out highlights here and there. And this one has a soft eraser on it, so it doesn't pull too much, too fast. Thank you. It's getting there, little by little. Right here, I'm gonna start working on under the nose bridge. And try to get the shape of the overall nose. I'm gonna have to go a bit darker overall since I gotta get rid of that other stuff from the sketch I did. But they look like a mustache for right now. And then I'm gonna start blending down this little area from the nostrils to the overall old shape that I had to get rid of it to make it invisible so it doesn't stick out as much. There we go, a little bit better. Now to work the other side. And then I'm gonna come back and sharpen up the lip edges on the top to get that super sharp highlight that's on top of the lip. Right there. Another little accident. Oh well. Always make sure you clear out your airbrush if you're gonna stop. There we go.